हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज योर हिस्ट्री क्लास स्टैंडर्ड 7th. लास्ट क्लास आई टॉट यू अबाउट फिरोज शाह. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट योर न्यू टॉपिक रजिया सुल्तान. लुक एट हियर, सी इज रजिया सुल्तान. ओके, सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट रजिया सुल्तान. रजिया सुल्तान टाइम ड्यूरेशन इज 1236 टू 1240 AD. Okay. She was the only Muslim woman ruler of the Delhi Sultanate. She successfully established peace and order. She was a progressive thinker. She left her female clothes and veil. She put on a coat and a cap. You can see. Coat and cap given. She rode elephants. She hunted and led the army like the male rulers. She tried to reduce the power of corrupt nobles. She started taking independent decisions. They conspired against her. So she was ultimately defeated and killed in 1240 AD. She died like a brave soldier. So simply you understand that she was succeeded by his daughter Razia Sultan in 1236 to 1240 AD. She was the only woman rulers of the Delhi Sultanate, but the nobles did not like the idea. So, according to this Razia Sultan, I will ask you two important question. How Razia Sultan was died? Who defeated Razia Sultan? So you have to write yourself. Now the next topic is Nasiruddin Mahmud. His time duration is 1246 to 1266 AD. Nasiruddin Mahmud was only 17 years old when he ascended the throne. He left administration in the hand of Balwan, who was the prime minister and his father-in-law. Balwan was a prominent member of the group of 14. Nasiruddin was a puppet in his hands. Nasiruddin died in 1266 AD. So according to this paragraph, I will ask you two important question. Number one, who is Nasiruddin Mahmud? Second, in which year Nasiruddin Mahmud came to the throne of Delhi? Okay. Our next topic is Ghiyasuddin Balwan. Look at this picture. He is Ghiyasuddin Balwan. His time duration is 1266 to 1288 AD. After the death of Nasiruddin, Balwan became the Sultan in 1266 AD. However, in reality, he was ruling since the last 20 years as the prime minister. Therefore, the achievements of Balwan are seen in 40 years, 20 years as the prime minister and 20 years as the sultan. The sultanate was surrounded by several difficulties. When he took the throne, he adopted the policy of iron and blood. It means use of military power rather than diplomatic talks. He took several measures to end the problem of Sultanate. So several major problem which is given in here, point wise I am giving. Number one, he dissolved Turkani Chahalgani. He introduced the customs of Sajda and Tebos. Sajda means touching the ground with the forehead. Tebos means kissing the feet of the king. Second, He ruthlessly suppressed the stubborn Rajput rulers who defeated the local chief. Point third, he punished the rebellious governor of Awadh and Sindh. Point four, his toughest campaign was against Bengal. Tughril Beg was the governor of Bengal. He revolted and declared independence. Balwant suppressed the revolt. Tughril and many, including his family members, were killed. Bughra Khan was made the governor. He was the son of Balwant. Point 5. The Mongols frequently attacked from the northwest boundaries. He constructed a chain of fort along the northwestern boundaries. He reorganized the army. He made his son Muhammad the governor of Multan. Prince Muhammad successfully protected the boundary. He was killed in one of the battles. This broke the back of the Balwant. He died soon after in 1288 AD. Balwant is regarded as the consolidator of the Delhi Sultanate. He cleared forest and made road safer. Trade and agriculture improved during his rule, but he is criticized for introducing the sajda and pebos. These were against the principles of Islam. Amir Khusrau was his court poet who wrote poetry in Persian and Hindwai. Amir Khusrau was called the singing bird of India. So according to this full paragraph of Balwant, I will ask you three important questions. Number one, what is sajda and pebos? Number two, who was called the singing bird of India? Question third, who among the following Sultan of Delhi Sultanate adopted policy of blood and iron? So today you have to complete your Razia Sultan, then Nasiruddin Muhammad and Balwant. Next class we will start our new chapter. Thank you.